नमस्ते, वेलकम टू ग्रीट टैरो। सो हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू आर डूइंग गुड। सो इफ़ यू आर न्यू हियर, इफ़ यू लाइक माई कॉन्टेंट, प्लीज़ सपोर्ट माई चैनल, और इफ़ यू हैव ऑलरेडी सपोर्टेड मी, थैंक यू सो वेरी मच। सो व्हेनेवर यू सब्सक्राइब, प्लीज़ प्रेस ऑन द नोटिफिकेशन बेल फॉर मोर अपडेट्स। ओके, सो इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स आई हैव माई इंस्टाग्राम पेज लिंक, इफ़ यू वॉन्ट टू फॉलो मी देयर, गो एंड गिव इट अ फॉलो। एंड द डेक्स दैट आई विल बी यूजिंग इन दिस रीडिंग विल ऑल्सो बी लिस्टेड इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स। ओके, so today's pick a card reading is about higher self messages, what your higher self wants you to know. So we have three mandala here, so you can select from this three, you can select one. Okay, so for group number one we have this one. For group number two we have this photo, blue mandala. And for group number three, so close your eyes, relax, connect with yourself, then select a photo that calls to you intuitively. Okay, so if you want more time, please pause the video. The timestamps will be listed in the description box, go ahead and watch it accordingly. Okay, so I'm gonna go with group number one. Group number one, if you chose this mandala, let's see what is your message, what your higher self wants you to know right now. So your higher self is telling you to seek that validation from within. You have been seeking validation from other people all the time. Now it's to seek the validation from within yourself. It's not the time to be very, very perfect, okay? It's the time to create something that you love, okay? It's not the time to be like putting a lot of effort. You know, you can create things without putting too much effort also. Sometimes we, you know, for example, if you're an artist and you are like trying to paint, but you're not feeling it, that painting will not be good, right? You have to feel that. And when you are like doing it effortlessly, it will be magic. So don't put too much effort. If you are in a relationship where you're putting too much effort, maybe that relationship is not giving you the thing, right? Maybe if you are putting too much effort on something. So it's time to let go of that thing, okay? Or maybe for some of you, it's like you are artist, you have a lot of creative ideas, but sometimes you force your ideas. Don't try to force anything. Take your time, relax, and then come back. You will be able to do it in a perfect way. And remember, you are perfect. You are perfect in your own way, okay? Everyone, you know, life cannot be perfect. Remember that. Your work cannot be perfect, because there will be people who will find, this is not good, that is not good. There will be people who will say something bad. There will be people who will criticize you, but it's okay. You need to accept that there are people like that, but you don't have to take their energy, right? So believe in yourself, validate yourself. Like, yeah, for some of you, you criticize your work. Maybe you're an artist, you criticize your work, you feel like your work is not good enough. Maybe you're learning a new skill and you're like, no, until I'm perfect, I'll not post it on the social media, I'll not show it to other people, okay? So it's like your higher self is saying, if you're working on something, if you're working on a skill, if you have a hobby that you want to build, you know, if you have a hobby that you want to make it in a career, just go for it, take one step, you know, post it, and then you can learn from your mistakes, and it's okay. You don't have to be perfect. Sometimes we wait for that time, oh, I'll learn this all thing and then I'll do that. No, you can post it, and at the same time you can learn also, like teach. For some of you, it's like you can teach and learn at the same time, like that. You can learn and then teach. So I'm getting that energy. You can post and you can get good at it, right? So just, if you want to open that Instagram page, open and post it, give it to the world, show your skills to the world, and maybe they will, you know, when you do that, you will get a different opportunity, and that is what is coming here. Look, door to romance and the world. With this world card, there is a lot of love coming from different parts of the world. That is what I feel like. So maybe if you are an artist or something, like whatever skill you have, don't be afraid to show it to the world, because I feel you will get validation from the people you never thought of, okay? Maybe you will not get the validation from near and dear ones, you will get the validation from different people. Maybe for some of you, if you have been dating, maybe you will date a person who is like, like, yeah, I'm getting that also energy. Your higher self is like, if you have a connection with a person who is like, not from your country, from different country, and you are like, but you have this limited belief. What if other people not approve of this relationship? So your higher self is telling you it's time to trust your heart. If this person makes you feel happy, if this person give you the things you want in your life, then it's time to do that. It's time to get out of your limited belief. But we live in a society that sometimes it's difficult, I know it, but this is what your higher self is saying. Yeah, have faith and inner strength. Look, you're very strong people. You can conquer all the obstacles. You know, you are so strong that naysayers cannot touch your heart. If someone is criticizing you, you are not going to take that energy of theirs. You are very strong people. You have this fiery energy. You have this passion inside of you. You have this skill. You have this passion. You have this. Show it to the world. Get out of your comfort zone. You have, maybe for some of you, you have a box full of paintings that you haven't shown to other people. It's time to show it to the other people. Maybe other people will want to buy it. Maybe you are judging your work too harshly or something like that. If that's the case, don't judge your work. You are perfect the way you are. Okay, remember that. And look, faith, have faith, trust in your skills. This is the pile where the higher self is saying, trust in your own capability, trust in your skills. You are very talented. At the same time, you don't trust in your own talents. You feel like that you lack this, you lack that, because you might be seeing other people who are like at the top. Maybe you are comparing your beginning journey to other people's, like they are in the higher level and you're comparing that. No, I'm not good at my painting is not good as theirs, or my skill is not good as theirs. No, you can keep on, you can work on it. At the same time, you can show it to the world also, right? There might be people who like your work, right? So don't put yourself in box. Don't sell yourself short because you feel like it's not good. That doesn't mean it's not good. Have faith in yourself. You know, you are very, your thing, you, whatever you're doing is, whatever you're creating in your life, it's good, it's perfect, the way it is, it's unique. Yeah, look, you have this Five of Pentacles mindset, I feel like, look, about your skill, that it's not worthy enough, it's not good enough, that I'm not talented enough, I have to work too much for this. No, you don't. You can achieve things by smart work. You don't have to put that much energy. For some of you, I even feel like you force yourself to do work. Maybe you are workaholics. So sometimes it's important to take break, okay? Don't force yourself too much, because you can achieve things with effortlessness, okay? Look at your last card here. She rests to create. You have a lot of ideas. You will have a lot of... For this pile, I'm getting creative success, okay? You have a lot of ideas. Take that idea, work on that idea. You will be able to have that success. You don't have to have this lack mentality, whether people will like it or not, whether people will validate my work or not, whether I am good at it. And what happens when we think like that? We will feel like, no, people will not like my work. People will reject me. You're feeling like that. No, trust in your skill. And with this Two of Wands, work on your skill. Be courageous. Have faith in your skill. I feel with this card, like this person is like, yeah, I can achieve whatever I desire to. That should be your mindset, right? Your higher self is saying you can create whatever you want to create. But the thing that is coming in between your creation is you, your own thoughts. Your own, you feel like that you are not worthy enough, because maybe this is your limited belief that was instilled in you in your past, right? Sometimes our parents don't encourage us. They say, oh, this is not good. Oh, your painting is not good. Maybe they have told you like that. And because of that, you're feeling that your things are not perfect. You're not, the work you do is not perfect. It's not good. People will not allow, give you that good comments or something, whatever you're thinking. Get out of it. It's your limited belief. You are feeling it. That's the lack mindset you have. Your higher self is saying, get out of that lack mindset and believe in yourself. Believe in your creative ideas, because these creative ideas will give you success. whatever field you are in, doesn't matter, but your ideas will give you success. You are meant to show your skill to a larger audience than getting here. So yeah, trust yourself, have faith. You have that much passion inside you, inside of you. I'm getting this Queen of Wands energy. You are meant to be independent. You can do things by yourself. You have a lot of ideas you can work on. You don't have to take other people's energy. There will be naysayers. There will be people who will criticize you. That doesn't mean that you're not good. You're not worthy, right? And with this, look, she's so calm. She's doing her work so effortlessly. That is what you need to do. You don't have to force things. You don't have to do things, when you're painting, you don't have to think, oh, whether this will be perfect or not, or whether people will like it or not. No, when you work, when you paint, or whatever skill you do, just do it happily. Like, do it effortlessly, like, do it with love, and do it like, yeah, I can do it, this is good, I'm good at it, and see that positive affirmations and do it. Your higher self is like telling you, because you are talented people, and you're thinking that you're not, and that is what you need to let it go, okay? That's all for group number one, bye, take care. Hello group number two, if you chose this mandala, then this is your reading with me. So let's see what are your messages from your higher self, what your higher self wants you to know. So your higher self is telling you that you are very very beautiful people. You operate from your heart center. They are saying that you have been working on your heart center, you have been healing your past, you have been overcoming your past, and you're moving towards a brighter future. So I'm getting a number 5. So you are going through a change, positive change. So you have gone through a lot of challenges in your life, okay? You are overcoming that challenges. You have dealt a lot. So yeah, with this 5 energy is all about changes. Sometimes it's difficult, right? It's very challenging, but you have overcome this, and now you are moving forward to the number 6. And the number 6 is all about harmony in relationship, harmonious career, happiness, right? Receiving things. I'm getting that vibe. Your heart center is opening up. You're healing your wounded heart, okay? Maybe in the past many people have taken advantage of you guys, and your heart has been, like, so many times it has been cut into 3 parts, like, right? Sometimes we feel like heartbreak. You have gone through a lot of heartbreak, but you are stitching your heart back again, and you're healing. And yeah, you are in this healing process, and you are coming back to life. You are full of love now. You're radiating love, and your higher self is very happy that you have overcome so much in your life, and you are moving forward with a lot of passion in your heart, with a lot of love. Even though you had a lot of people who have taken advantage of you, but these things haven't stopped you from being the good person you are. You have always been the kind one, and you are now also, okay? Maybe for some of you, you had that bitter feeling, but you are letting go of that bitter feeling now, and you're understanding that everything happens for a reason. Every person came into your life for a reason, and they have taught you a lesson, and now you are like, okay, it happened for a reason, and I'm okay, and I'm moving forward. So yeah, a lot of healing energy, lot of opening up. For some of you, I even feel like your chakras are getting balanced, because we have green color, we have purple color, we have yellow color, we have blue color, we have every color here in this mandala, right? So I feel for many of you, every chakra is aligning. Maybe you're very called to do yoga. If you're called to do yoga, just go and do it. Maybe you're called to do meditation, just go and do it. I don't know, I'm getting yoga. Maybe for some of you, you want to learn yoga. I'm not saying everyone here, but for some of you, I feel you want to learn yoga. And you will be like, oh, I will do it tomorrow, I'll do it tomorrow, or something like that. So it's time to do it now. It's the time, okay, to do everything that you feel like doing, okay? So if you want to learn a new skill, now is the time. I feel like that is what your higher self wants you to know. Yeah, look, angel of love. Yeah, there is so much love. You are operating from your heart center. That is what your higher self is saying. You don't have to worry about. You have healed your heart. I feel for many of you, healing your heart, or maybe for some of you, you have healed your heart. Now you are like, you're moving forward in your life. You're ready for this new beginning. You're ready for this new start. And your higher self is like, appreciating you. You are so courageous. You have done so much. You have overcome so many obstacles. You're full of love. You're radiating love. And when we radiate love, we get that love back. So universe has your back. Your higher self is saying universe has your back. Spirit has your back. Your higher self has your back. You don't have to worry about anything. So if it's possible, if you have rose quartz crystal, you can carry that crystal. Okay. Or maybe if you like to use roses or something, you can just use roses also. I'm getting roses. For some of you, I feel like you will receive some roses. That is also, I feel like. But definitely, there is a lot of love coming towards you. A lot of angelic support. There is a lot of love from the divine. And I feel for you guys, your life is going to be very beautiful. And you have done a lot of work. That's why. You have done a lot of shadow work. It's not easy. Maybe people will be like, oh, this person is so lucky. No, you have done so much, right? And because of that, yeah, luck is, I feel for this pile, your higher self is saying, yeah, luck is now on your side, okay? Group number two, wow. Yeah, rest and rejuvenation. You are healing. So for some of you, I told you, whether you're called to do yoga or meditation, go for it. If you want to learn that, just go for it. Maybe you want to do an online course on that. If you are feeling like that, just go for it. For some of you, you can learn it by yourself also. I feel like maybe you can use YouTube channel. There are so many free videos on YouTube. You can use that. But definitely a cycle is ending for you guys with this 19 number. And with this 19 number, I'm getting the sun energy in tarot, right? The 19 number. Oh, wow. I just saw the sun. There is a lot of happiness because you're connecting with yourself. You are making a connection with your higher self also. So, yeah, this pile is like you are going to listen to your own heart and you're making decisions from your heart. You're not going to listen to other people. Even if someone says something or give advice to you, first you will trust your heart, and then only you will do the things. I feel like that. So you are very connected with your heart space. And when a person is connected with their heart space, things align. Yeah, I feel like that. And you're going to be very peaceful. You're going to be very calm. You are going to attract a lot of your wishes because you are vibrating you are in a very higher vibration, guys. You are higher vibrational beings. That is what I feel. Okay, so even if there are people around you who are not that high vibe, it's important you protect your energy. Okay, maybe you take other people's energy also. That is also quite possible. So sage, doing spiritual bath, lighting candle, meditating with white light, that will help you guys. But you don't have to worry about it, okay? Because you are divinely guided, you're divinely protected, and definitely you are up for new beginnings. The sun is shining on you. You have a lot of ideas. So if you are in this creative field, your higher self is saying, just meditate and you will get a lot of ideas, right? While meditating, you might get a lot of ideas. Take that ideas, work on that ideas. Work with love. Like for you guys, love is very important, right? Whatever you do, do it with love. If you cook, do it with love. Okay, so your higher self is also telling you to be in the present moment. Okay, don't think too much about future, but I feel like you're getting there. You're slowly but surely you're getting there. You're trying to live in the present moment. Okay, for some of you, you are practicing mindfulness also. I feel like, okay, maybe you are very called to watch like Buddhist teachings or something like that. Maybe you're watching that, I don't know. But definitely I feel a lot of wisdom is there inside of you. And yes, focus on love. When you focus on love, everything is will align for you guys. Yeah, we have soul flame, Radha. Yes, you are rediscovering yourself. You are finding yourself back. Yes, I told you about this healing and all, right? You're connecting with your own higher self, and your higher self is very happy with that, because your higher self is like, yes, you're finally connecting with me. You know, you are doing the exact things I'm saying to you, and you are rediscovering yourself. You are connecting with the things you always wanted to do. You're connecting with the people that you liked. That is also I'm feeling like. You're connecting with the people you love. You're connecting with your own intuition. You're connecting with your childhood hobbies. Okay, for some of you, you're connecting with your innocence and your healing. There is a lot of harmony coming for you guys. If you're in a relationship, expect a lot of harmony, a lot of love in your relationship. If you're a mother, you will get a lot of love from your kids. And you will be giving that love. And when we give that love, we receive. Because you are made up of love. Look at that lotus. The lotus comes from a very muddy environment, right? And you are like that. You are like this lotus. Yes, you have endured a lot of things. You have seen all the bad things in your life. Now it's time to shine. Now it's time to bloom. Now it's time to connect with your own divinity. Now it's time to, people would be like, wow, this lotus is so good. But that kind of energy. Oh, wow, this is so good. This is so beautiful. People will be appreciating you for you. Right? Maybe you have been always addressed as someone's husband, someone's wife, someone's husband, or something like that. Now you will be addressed for yourself. Oh, this person, right? That kind of energy I'm getting. You're getting your identity back. Something about that, right? Look, we have victory and we have transformation. Look at the fire. You have lot of passion. You are passionate about something. Keep on following that passion, because this passion of yours will give you victory. For this pile, you are going to be successful in all areas of your life. That is what I feel, because you are operating from your heart center. Your aura is like in green color. I feel like, oh my God, wow, your energies are very good. Your higher self is like, yeah, ready. Be ready for the success. You are meant to achieve that success, because you are so loving. You're so kind. You're so caring. You have given so much to other people. Now it's the time to receive the things, right? Now it's time to have that recognition. For some of you, you have been working on an idea, but you haven't been recognized. But finally, you're going to get that recognition. Going to get that rewards. For some of you, yeah, I told you, you are getting your identity back, okay? For some of you, maybe it's like you haven't worked for quite a while. Now you're getting a new job and you're gonna do that. Maybe for some of you, you are doing something from your home, and that is going to be very victorious. But whatever it is, you are transforming. You're becoming the best version of yourself, and your higher self is really proud of you guys. And we have 24 number. Look at that owls, lot of wisdom. Your intuition is on point. Okay, that is what I feel like. And again, look at the number 6. I'm getting the life path 6 for some of you. Definitely 6, Cancer sign also I'm getting. I'm getting water signs. I'm getting water sign. I'm getting Cancer sign. Like, I'm getting the Queen of Cups energy also for some of you. Maybe you are healers, maybe you're intuitives, maybe you read tarot. Whatever you do, keep on working on your passion, because this passion of yours will transform your life. At the same time, it will transform other people's life. Maybe you are a Reiki healers, or you want to learn Reiki or yoga, whatever spiritual thing. If you're called to do that, go ahead and do it, because you're going to be very good at it. And I feel with this, lot of informations are going to be revealed to you guys. I feel for some of you, you have a lot of untapped potential inside of you. You're going to tap on that. Okay, so you know, maybe for some of you, you have discovered something about yourself with this Radha. You know, you have already discovered something, I feel you're going to discover more about yourself. Okay, and you will be surprised by how strong and how creative and how talented you are. You are going to uncover treasures within yourself. A lot of information is coming for you guys. Trust your intuition. Your ancestors are with you. And this card is also telling you that your ancestors, your loved ones on the other sides are sending you a lot of love, a lot of healing energy. And they are praying for you guys. Okay. And yes, if you have dealt with any injustice in your life, as I told you, you are healing your heart. And if you have dealt with any injustice, you are going to get the justice also. Okay, with this card. That is what I feel like. So yeah. So trust what you feel. Trust, right? Trust your heart center. Okay, that is what your higher self is saying. And yes, your future is going to be very beautiful, and trust in it. You have a lot of wisdom, and trust in your own wisdom, trust in yourself. And yes, you're becoming such a beautiful people, right? So your higher self is proud of you, group number two. Bye-bye, group number two. Take care. Group number three, if you chose this mandala, then this is your reading. I feel your root chakra is healing, okay? When our root chakra is healed, our financial our relationships are all balanced. So that is what I feel for you. Look at the green color. So yeah, when I was shuffling your cards, I felt like abundance is yours. For some of you, abundance in money. For some of you, abundance in relationship, because you're healing your root chakra. That is what I feel like, okay? So the first card you have is walking away. You're walking away from something that is not good for you, okay? Or for some of you, you have already walked away from something, and if you have already done, look, what is the next card? Blossoming abundance. So I was actually hearing abundance, and then this card popped up. I was like, wow. So yeah, you are walking away from the situation that is not good for you. Maybe if you have this limited belief of lack, you're walking away from your own limited beliefs, and you're doing good guys. But yeah, group number two also was very good, and you also are you're trusting yourself. You are, look at this woman. She is so courageous. She is so bold. She is taking action. She is not afraid anymore. She is like, no, I don't want to be in this palace anymore. I can build my own palace. That kind of energy, I feel like you're getting out of your comfort zone, and you're making your own abundance. So for some of you, it can be like walking away from a relationship to a more better relationship. Maybe for some of you, it's a career that you're walking away to a better career, to a better job opportunity. For some of you, you have a lot of limited beliefs about money, because our parents put a lot of, maybe in your past, you have seen your parents struggling with money. And because of that, you have that limited belief that you will not be able to achieve that much income or something like that. You are letting go of that limited belief, and you are accepting that you can make your own abundance. You are abundant. And for some of you, I even see that you're doing positive affirmations. So keep on working that positive affirmations, because that is working. You're definitely completing a cycle of like lack. I feel like that you have been in this lack mentality for so long. Now you're like walking away from that, okay? That is what I feel like. You have been always in this comfort zone, or maybe you felt like that you have to be in this comfort zone, otherwise you will not expand, or something like that. You're getting out of that. You have been in this box. Now you're like opening up the box, and you're getting out of the box, and you're running away from that thing because you don't want to be in that box anymore. So yeah, you're growing, you're expanding. This growth can be like spiritual growth for some of you financially, some of you relationship wise, like attracting good people. That's what I feel. You're attracting more stable relationships, more stability into your life, secure relationship, good co-workers, good relationship, good friends, okay? And yes, abundance is gonna smile on you. Fortune is smiling on you, right? Number three, maybe you are, number three is going to be important for you guys. Maybe you're a Gemini sign. I'm getting that also, and I'm getting the energy of life path three numbers also. Maybe you're born on number three. Why I'm just attracted to this three number? Maybe you need to Yeah, maybe your life path number 33 also, that is also quite possible. But look at that, there is coins here, there is so much happiness, there is so much growth waiting for you guys. For some of you, it's like your higher self is saying that get out of your limited belief, get out of that thing that is not serving you, and because there is abundance waiting for you guys. But for some of you, I really feel that you're letting go of the things that is not serving you, moving towards a better future. I feel you have made this change, right? We have High Priestess, Lovers, oh God, and Speed. Something is coming fast. Some person is coming fast. For some of you, there is a new love happening. This person is your soulmate and this person is coming quickly. And your higher self is saying when you will meet this person, you will know it. You will know it that this is the one. Something like that. Okay, with this High Priestess energy I'm getting. For many of you, this might be like a message you will be receiving intuitively about this soulmate. Okay, yeah, that is what I feel like. For some of you, you already know this person. Maybe they are living far away from you. Maybe they will travel and you will see them. That is also quite possible. But definitely there is a soulmate of yours that you are going to connect with. If you haven't met, then remember, this message is saying that this person is coming very quickly, very quickly. Okay, and you will know it intuitively. Your intuition is very strong in that. But definitely, yeah. And for others, if you're not like into the soulmate relationship and all, I feel you will get a message where you will make a decision. So if you have, yeah, you are going to you will get an opportunity, and when you will get this opportunity, trust your intuition, right? Because Lovers is also about choices, and we have High Priestess. So whenever you get an opportunity, trust your intuition and make that choice. If your intuition feels good, if you feel good when you get that opportunity, take that opportunity, because this opportunity will be very good for you guys. Okay, so yeah. So for some of you, it's like you're walking away from a job and you are gonna get a job very quickly. You're walking away from a relationship and you're meeting this soulmate of yours very quickly. Something about that. Like your higher self is like, for some of you, if you have done this part, yes, you're gonna meet them soon. You're going to get this opportunity soon. And if you haven't done that, your higher self is like, move away from this thing, because good things are waiting for you guys, right? Look. The divine director, intervention and purpose. Divine intervention is occurring. Know that you're being guided. Happiness is your purpose. So if you're being guided to move away from the specific job, you know that intuitively, right? For some of you, if you haven't done that, if you're not trusting your intuition, like your higher self is like, just trust your intuition. Because when you trust this intuition, things are going to be very good, because divine is guiding you. you right? Yeah. So yeah, take one step to happiness, guys. Don't stress too much. Get out of your comfort zone. Get out of your limited beliefs, because there are so many good things waiting for you guys. And your higher self is like, trust yourself. Trust your intuition. Yeah, they're not showing the bigger picture. Things are hidden from you right now. You don't know whether you will have that job, whether you will. You are like going into an unknown territory. Like, but your higher self is like, this unknown territory will give you a lot of happiness, because you're guided by the spirit. You're guided by your angels. Okay, because you came here to be happy, you came here to be abundant, you came here to have good relationships. For some of you, you are making a good relationship with yourself, your subconscious mind. You are letting go of your subconscious beliefs, okay? You're letting go of that. I see that also. Things are happening very quickly here. So once you move away from that thing, if you have already moved away, things are going to be very quick. Things are going to happen very quickly, very fast. Fast movement. For some of you, travel. Definitely, you can travel to a different place. If you have been making a choice on that, yes, travel is there. Wow, blessings of the Supreme Being. So yeah, there is a blessing coming soon for you guys. You have been praying about something. Your higher self is saying that is manifesting for you guys. Maybe your blessing is you are uh, your blessing is about a relationship that you have been manifesting, maybe it's about your career that you have been manifesting, maybe it's about travel that you have been manifesting, but whatever you're manifesting, remember you're divine. With these two cards, I have to say your divine is with your higher self is like telling you, don't worry about anything, don't worry that whether you will make a wrong choice, because if you trust your heart, you are not going to make a wrong choice, because this choice is for your own good. This choice of yours will give you the happiness. Okay, I feel like that because divine is giving you the blessing. Okay, a blessing is coming very soon, your higher self is saying. So don't worry to get out of this phase, your limited beliefs. Maybe sometimes we sell ourselves short. Don't do that. Think big for yourself. Think big, like you have a lot of potential. Dream big, because when you dream big, you will be able to manifest that. Okay, that is also I feel like, but definitely a lot of abundance for some of you. I'm also getting this financial gain happening very soon. Maybe if you do business or something, maybe your business ideas are going to be very good, something like that. But definitely there is a lot of subconscious healing. Okay, we have number 6, we have number 7, we have number 8, right? Look at that. We have number 2, we have number 3, 6, 7, 8. Right? Interesting, because you're moving up. You're moving towards your manifestation. So don't worry. Choose happiness and happiness will come to you. So that is the thing. Right, be courageous, walk away courageously from something. If something is not good for you guys, if something makes you unhappy or something that is not aligned with your heart center, it's time to move away, because more good things are coming for you guys. Okay, so yeah, that is what I feel for you guys. That's it for group number 3. Bye bye, take care.